continue to fellowship with him, you continue to grow and become all that he wants you to be. You must choose for yourself. He's not going to make you. He's not going to make you. And I want to hurry and share with you this stuff you've been hearing. Just a little talk with you. Make everything all right. I'm going to tell you. It won't.
All right. All right.
I talked to him one time. I got to go back and talk again. I talk with him again. I got to go back and talk to him again. There's something about the name of Jesus. There is something about his name that makes me want to go down on bended knee. There's something about the name of Jesus that I can't get enough of. Jesus. Jesus, oh, the precious Jesus. Oh, how I love the name Jesus. The name Jesus is music to my ear. The name Jesus is strength to my soul. The name Jesus is salvation. The name Jesus is hope. In the midst of my hopelessness, oh, how I love Jesus. I love Jesus because he first loved me. For God so loved Larry that he gave his only begotten son, that if Larry would believe on him, Larry would not perish but have everlasting life. Brother, I'm done now. I got my shout out. I'm done now. I'm through. I'm done. I'm done. Brother Swain looking away. Bro, you getting carried away now. I'm done. I'm done. If you really love Jesus, and only Jesus can make a difference. Only Jesus can make a difference in your life. New hope can't change you. Pastor Polk can't change you. Only Jesus can change you. Only Jesus can change you. This is an exciting church. These are exciting times. Let me close on this note. Brother Colquitt, it's not the size of a church that counts. Our last station, we built a $4 million building and we didn't have 500 members. Brothers, Brother Deacons, folk who come in and say, they ask, Brother Pope, y'all don't have a lot of members. How y'all do all this? And I just stood there, Brother Beatty, and I stuck my chest out, and I didn't get cocky. I just told them, we don't count numbers, we make numbers count. You'll get that on the way home. You'll get that on the way home. But it ain't about numbers. It's about Deacon Roberts. It's about committed hearts. Amen. committed hearts. When hearts are committed,
brothers and sisters, you ain't gotta keep stretching. I've been here with you for 4 years, and you've never heard this preacher ask you, "Well, we didn't quite get enough, so let's go around another time." This preacher gets up and tell you what we need to start. And then I look at the crowd, sisters and brothers, and I said, this is a $500 crowd, so we all maybe do $500. And here's what every person has to give to do $500, and then you don't have to keep calling for that money back. Amen?
Amen.
And see, God is going to keep his word.
Yes,
God is going to be true to his word. So you just trust his word.
Amen.
That's all I'm saying to you. God's purpose for the church is that his message be made available to all people.
Yeah.
That's the word. You ain't got to tell them what Pastor Pope said. Tell them what the word said. And if you tell them anything, you tell them that Pastor Pope said the word said. Because I'm going to tell you what the word said. You don't come here every Sunday to hear what I say.
Amen.
You come to hear what the word said.
Amen.
What the word said.
Right.
Now this is my invitation to you. If you really want life changing and life changing effects in your life, ask Jesus Christ to come into your heart. Invite him in. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come into my heart. I'm helpless. I'm hopeless. I'm naked. I'm afraid. I'm lonely. I need your assurance. And you know what he does? He comes immediately into your life. He gives you hope. He gives you help. He gives you security. He gives you the assurance that you need to know that when the going gets tough, he's still with you. See what he promised you? I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So who's going to sing? I'm going to invite you to a real relevant relationship with Jesus Christ. You may not be here in this sanctuary, but if you want Jesus into your life, to come into your life, he can do it right where you are. All you need is to invite him in, ask him to come into your life.
Gonna fulfill every promise. Hallelujah.
Now unto him who's able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the throne of majesty, be dominion and power forever and ever. All the people of God said amen. Before we leave, I have an important announcement I want to echo to New Hope and for those who are listening in our live streaming audience. Vote in America, and for people of Negro descent, Civil Rights Voting Act of 1965. Many of people who look just like us died, gave lives. Churches were burned. Folk who look like us burned up. Because all they wanted was a right to vote. And every 10 years, New Hope, check this out. Don't take pastor's word for it. You check it out for yourself. Every 10 years, the Congress of this nation goes back to renew that to give us the right to vote. My brothers and sisters, since I was 18, I ain't gonna tell you how long ago that's been. Since I was 18 years old, I've always voted.
Amen.
My great-grandpa had to. My great-grandpa was a slave. My grandpa had to pay a poll in order to vote. And I was a part of that where you voted, you had to vote twice to vote once. I was a part of that. I walked in back doors, Brother Johnny.
Amen.
I went in back doors, Brother Cooper. I sat in the back and ate in the kitchen, Brother Swain, with the cook. I paid $10 for three hamburgers for me and my two brothers. And we had to eat them in the back.
Yes, sir. I know you're right. Yes, sir.
You ask me if I'm gonna vote, hell yeah, I'm gonna vote. I'm gonna vote. As a matter of fact, I voted on the 6th. I got my ballot on the 6th. I voted on the 6th. I took it to the mailbox. I took it to the post office and paid the extra 15 cents to make sure my ballot got in. Go vote. Go vote. And now you hear what Pastor said. I didn't tell you who to vote for. But go vote. Go vote. And you ain't gonna hear this no more. I'm gonna tell you that now. Go vote. Go vote. It's very crucial that you vote. Because if some of this other stuff have its way, they're gonna take the voting right from you. And I don't have to talk this to you. But we have never gotten our help. I told you this 4 years ago. Our help has never come from the White House. Our help has always come from the Lord. I wasn't studying about no stimulus. I ain't waiting on no stimulus. My bills don't get paid because of stimulus. I work the job. And I'm not too proud, brothers and sisters, to work.
Amen.
Well, I want to hear to share with you. This word that I just preached to you says if you don't work, you don't eat. And I'm not on some corner asking somebody to give me something. Brothers in this church knows this. Whether I got it, they don't know that I got it. If I got it, they don't know I got it. If I don't have it, they don't know I got it. I don't have it.
Because the Lord's going to take care of us.
Amen.
Somebody here knows that. God bless you. May the Lord strengthen you. Here's our prayer.
Lord,
hallelujah.